Please see the link in the description to download a worksheet for this video. Experiments can be dangerous. If you are a child, never do experiments unless your parent, guardian, or adult educator says it's all right and is there with you the whole time. If you've not already done so, we suggest that you watch the video introducing light before watching this video. When many of us think of something going fast, we think of race cars. Some race cars go 200 miles per hour. If there was a straight road all around the Earth, a race car could go all the way around the Earth in just 5 days. But that's only if the driver went at full speed the whole time and never stopped the car for even a minute. But there's something else around us all the time that's much faster. Light travels more than 670 million miles per hour. Light can go around the entire world in the time it takes us to blink. We use the phrase light transmission when referring to how light travels when it's not interacting with something. In this video, we'll learn about light transmission, including the meaning of the words medium, translucent, transparent, and opaque, the speed of light, and how it's affected by various mediums, when we can versus when we can't see light, and light's path when it's transmitting through mediums. We'll start with some definitions. We use the word transparent to describe when we can see through something clearly. Clear air, water, and glass are all transparent to light, at least for short to medium distances. The word opaque refers to materials that block light transmission. A wall and door are opaque. The word translucent refers to materials that permit some light transmission, but distort the image so that it's blurry or changed in some other way. Next, we'll discuss the speed of light. In the vacuum of outer space, light travels more than 186,000 miles in just 1 second. Light can go between the Earth and Moon in less than 2 seconds. Light is the fastest thing in the universe. We abbreviate the value for the speed of light with the letter C. You may recognize that letter from the most famous equation in science. If this diamond was in a vacuum, then the light approaching it would go very fast. But once that light enters the diamond, it goes less than half its speed in a vacuum. And when that light exits from the diamond, it returns to its speed in a vacuum. In future videos, we'll discuss refraction, which is when light bends when passing from one medium to another, such as from air into water. The reason that light refracts is because it's hitting different speed limits in the different mediums. For example, in air, light travels at more than 186,000 miles per second. But in water, light slows to 140,000 miles per second. Next, we'll discuss when we can versus when we can't see light. This is a pretend scene. From a scientific perspective, what's wrong with the way this laser beam is shown? Although movies can be more entertaining when laser beams are shown like this, it's important to know the facts about lasers and other light, so that we stay safe around them. We can only see a light beam from the side that's going through something like dust or fog. If there's no dust or fog, as with this laser, then we can't see the light beam. In outer space, there's no dust or fog, so this light beam would be invisible. This red box is slightly above the moon. It's not between the sun and moon. That means there's no sunlight going through this box that's landing on the moon. Do you think there's any sunlight in this box right now? There's an enormous amount of sunlight that's going through this red box as sunlight goes past the moon. Here's a sketch of what the Earth and Moon look like as seen as though we could look down on the North Pole. Except for shadows behind the sun-facing sides of the Moon and Earth, sunlight is everywhere in this image. But we only see the sunlight that has reflected off the Moon and then comes towards Earth. Our final topic is light's path. Light's path can change when it reflects off objects like this mirror. Light's path can also change when it travels from one medium to another, such as during refraction. But in both of these cases, when the light is not reflecting or refracting, it transmits in a straight line. Likewise, there are other ways that light's path may change, which we'll discuss in more advanced videos. But the same rule applies, which is, when light isn't interacting with something, it transmits in a straight line. That observation applies to everything from sunlight to regular light bulbs and advanced lasers. Here's a summary of this video. Please pause the video to read this if you wish. If you're interested in practice tests that are similar to state exams, but with detailed, colorful explanations for each answer, then please see our apps in the App Store. Many of these are free and none expire or limit their function. Since we only make educational products for children, none of our apps have third-party advertising, in-app purchasing, or connect to the internet. Please subscribe if you'd like to be notified of future educational videos we make. Thanks for your attention.